How to protect your cloud storage and backups from ransomware. Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. In a previous article and video, I talked about how ransomware is nothing special when it comes to prevention. It's just malware. The same steps you take to protect yourself against malware are the steps that protect you from ransomware. Because of ransomware's devastating consequences, however, many people want additional assurance that they're protected, even if they accidentally allow such malware to reach their machine. In particular, two questions come up often. What about files stored in services like OneDrive or Dropbox? And what about backups stored on connected external hard drives? The great news here, there are approaches to specifically address those concerns. Now, I'm a big believer in regular automated image backups. Automation requires a destination for the backups, typically an external drive, that is always connected and ready. Now, the concern is that the ransomware might encrypt the files on your backup devices as it encrypts your data. This makes the typical ransomware protection advice, just restore the backup, impossible. Macrium Reflect has a feature called Image Guardian in its paid version to protect against exactly this. The concept is really simple. Only authorized applications, Macrium Reflect itself, and a couple of very specific exceptions, are allowed to do anything to the backup images. Even attempting to just delete such an image in Windows File Explorer generates an error and a notification that says, yeah, you can't do that. This blocks your backup images from unauthorized modification by malware. Now, of course, you can still delete the file from within Reflect, of course, but the bottom line here is that ransomware can't encrypt the file. I really appreciate this feature because it allows you to safely leave your external drive connected and therefore your backups can continue to run automatically without having to remember to reconnect the drive. And yes, other programs like Ease's To-Do, my other recommendation, have similar features. Cloud storage and synchronization services automatically back up the files you place in specific folders on your computer to the cloud. For example, if you regularly work in a OneDrive folder, those files are automatically copied to OneDrive.com online each time they change. This is an effective form of what I sometimes call near real-time backup. Every time you save the file, it's copied to the cloud, and possibly also to any other computers connected to the same OneDrive account. The concern here is that, okay, say ransomware comes along and encrypts your files. Because they've changed, those now encrypted files are automatically uploaded to the cloud, effectively overwriting your backup. Both OneDrive and Dropbox have had a form of file history for some time. What this means is that if a file has been changed or deleted, you can go to the website and restore the file to a previous version before the change was made. Both also have recycle bins. This can be burdensome, though, if ransomware encrypts, say, hundreds or thousands of your files. OneDrive allows you to restore your entire collection of files to a state prior to a given date. Was your machine infected by ransomware on Tuesday? Well, after you've cleaned your machine of the malware, reset your OneDrive to the state it was in on Monday. Boom. Encrypted files, gone. Original unencrypted files, back. Dropbox includes a similar feature called Rewind in its paid plans. It's interesting to note that both OneDrive and Dropbox refer to things just going wrong in their messages. Well, yeah, lots of different things can go wrong. The most likely cause for these features' appearance and popularity is the threat of ransomware. Now, neither of these features, image backup protection or cloud storage recovery, protects you from ransomware. These features only help after you've allowed your machine to become infected and after ransomware has done its damage. Do not let these features lull you into a false sense of security. you still need to be vigilant as you protect yourself from malware, of which ransomware is really only just one type. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/88362. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.